be sparking and rushing, mad light inside the dark. Call me Ghost Snatcher, just a brother for the rapture. I hang live, holding on strong, hard to capture. Extravagant, resurrect the track in his militant. And I react like a convict and start killing. It's manifesting, the gods work like appliances, dealing in my sacred life.
Before we go any further, just want to say today's video is going to be brought to you by Fandomion. If you want to buy some really awesome anime merch from My Hero Academia, Attack on Titan, and Haiku, and so many other anime, I recommend using my link in the description box to check them out. And there's free worldwide shipping on orders over $39. You'll also get an additional 5% off using my promo code down below. For any of you guys who might be interested or on the fence, I highly recommend checking out their website. Pay attention to the size chart. That'd be the biggest thing I would tell you guys. But with that being said, though, let's jump back into today's video. Yo, what's going on, everybody? It's your boy Naruto Explained here, bringing you guys another discussion for Boruto Naruto Next Generations, and this time it's going to be in regards to the anime, and I wanted to go ahead and discuss some of the stuff that happened in Boruto episode 223, because there's a little bit of a controversy that has sprouted up within a very vocal minority in the community, in my opinion, after the battle of Enogene versus Hoki. And I want to say right now, if you've not watched the anime episode, I highly recommend watching it. This was a really good fight. It really gave vibes of part one of Naruto, in my opinion. It really reminded me a lot of Shikamaru versus Temari, where the matchup was basically decided in the moment that the first jutsu got casted by Hoki. However, the thing that I'll say though is, in the aftermath of this fight, I've seen people say Sai was being a bad father by not sitting his son Enogene down and giving Enogene information about Hoki having the ability to resist any type of mental mind control, and that Sai was out of pocket by training Hoki to have a way to counter his son. So I want to clear up a few misconceptions I feel people have. So first and foremost, Sai didn't just sit down and say, oh, you're going to be going up against my son, this is what you have to do to counter. Sai stayed impartial throughout the entire thing. The other thing you also have to look at is the fact that the Chunin exams is meant to be a test of your capability as a leader in a battle type situation. When you're in a battle against somebody and you're leading a squad, a lot of the times when you go out on these missions, you're not going to have intel. A good example of this would be how Team 7 didn't have any type of intel on Victor and Deepa, and as a result they got absolutely washed. Shikamaru on the Sasuke retrieval mission, they didn't have any intel on the Sound 4 in terms of their battle capability, but they were able to come up with strategies and adjust on the fly. This Enogene versus Hoki battle was just a really good opportunity for both of these characters to go in battle and show how they would handle themselves in a battle situation if they're leading a team. And that's why I stress the fact that the way that Hoki was performing in that examination battle really showcased the fact that he would be a good Chunin. And the whole thing of, well, Enogene could have went to Sai and asked Sai about Hoki's abilities and get the information on the character. Yes, the intel was there for him to go to his father and ask those questions. However, I don't think Sai would have gave him that information simply for the fact that that defeats the whole purpose of the Chunin examination process. Now, this whole thing that people have that Sai's a bad father because he showed Hoki how to counter a jutsu that would belong to the Yamanaka clan, I would remind you that Hoki having to go on Anbu Black Ops missions, the whole thing that part one of Naruto really put into emphasis is the fact that a ninja's body holds all types of secrets, and if a ninja goes missing and gets killed on a mission, a lot of times villages like the Mist Village and even Konoha's Anbu Black Ops will seek out the body, retrieve it, and dispose of it that way. Stuff like village medicine, Keke Genkai, things of that nature do not fall in the hands of the enemy. We've seen how in part two of Naruto, how you had people like the Yamanaka clan who were able to read minds. You've seen how in the novels where people like Sasuke are able to use genjutsu in order to read the minds of people and look back into their memories. So it's one of those things where Sai teaching these genin how to resist any type of mental manipulation, that's very much in line with what the Anbu Black Ops would train you to do. And that's very much in line with what you've seen in the Naruto franchise, is that Knowledge is power. You want to prevent any type of knowledge from falling into the hands of the enemy. So I'm okay with Sai teaching Hoki how to do that. And when you really look at it, the anime goes out of its way to say that Inojin, the problem that he ran into was that he got too cocky and confident. If he just sort of went straight for the surrender after taking control, he would have won the matchup. And when it comes to Hoki using that jutsu, I'm 100% okay with it, because when we find out the level of training that Sai put him through, it's a jutsu that is directly stated, if it goes wrong, you end up destroying your entire mind. So that was a high risk, high reward situation. I think that that's a beautiful payoff. And I don't think that Hoki gets enough credit for what he did in this episode. Like, people were rightfully getting super hyped over that giant Earth Release jutsu that he used that covered the entire Chunin Exams arena. Like, that is some overpowered skill. That's like some Sound 4 level skill right there. Like, if you recall, I believe it's Jirobo who has that huge Earth Release jutsu that he used against Choji. You're looking at something on that scale. Maybe if you want to like highball it, you can get to that jutsu that was used against Gaara and Rock Lee in the Sasuke retrieval arc by Kimimaro. But like, the fact of the matter is that people rightfully looked at that jutsu, but I was more impressed at what he did with this mental defense that he used. Like, that is absolutely nice. Like, I get it, Sakura was able to mentally resist and that was done more so in a gag moment, but the method of training that Sai put Hoki through, somewhere Danzo smiling from a nice warm place where he's getting a nice suntan and has some devils with Sharingan poking him with metal sticks, somewhere Danzo is smiling, because that is a training method that Danzo would have used in the Root organization. So again, it's a high risk, high reward payoff, and I absolutely love it. Just looking at that fight, there were a few moments where Inojin kind of blew it if you really look at it. So for instance, when Hoki used that Earth Release jutsu, he went to the academy with him, so he should have known that Hoki has a photographic memory. So it's one of those things where overlooking that potential piece of information is something that could have bit him in the butt if he would have kept his cool and noticed that Hoki was running around and put two and two together. He could have stopped him, which that in itself would have been huge. Also, when Hoki's throwing the shuriken and the kunai and Inojin's kind of jumping out the way and looking absolutely shocked, he's getting thrown off of his rocker. And it's one of those things where if he would have took a deep breath, he would have realized that his best options were, one, going to the sky like he did, or two, maintaining his location and attempting to use some type of sensory jutsu. I know that the episode where he was helping out the sensory team kind of showed that Inojin is pretty much hit or miss when it comes to sensory jutsu. Towards the end of the episode, he was able to lock onto the chakra signature, but it's one of those things, we haven't seen him use it since then, so you could argue that was a bit of a fluke. But I think it would have been nice for him to actually try that. But the fact of the matter is this, he had a few opportunities to really turn that fight on his head. And I think that his shortcoming goes back to his own arrogance. He took the time to gloat, and that's what cost him. So at the end of the day, no, I don't think that Sai was in the wrong for training Hoki and having Hoki learn a jutsu like this. Hoki's going on Anbu Black Ops missions. I don't think it makes him a bad father. And Inojin said it himself, he's going to win it based on his own skill. Going to Sai was an option, but he wanted to prove that he himself was worthy. So I want to know from you guys, do you guys still feel that Sai did the right thing by being neutral, not giving either one of them advice before the Chunin exams? Let me know down in the comment section below. But as always, guys, if you like anything I had to say, don't forget to comment, rate, subscribe, and share. Thank you so much for watching to the end. Have an awesome day, guys.